And I'd like to welcome you to AnnieJr, 5th Grade Play. You are in for a treat tonight. I was able to see the show this morning, and they've done a phenomenal job. I know students have worked for months, learning parts, preparing the stage, the scenery, and it was only possible through the many hours of direction and masterful, patient direction of Mr. Belanger and Ms. Carroll. So a big round of applause. I'd also like to thank our 5th Grade committee, because they also have been working for months on this, planning and preparing every detail of the concession stand and getting the flowers and popcorn and candy. And so we'd also like to thank them for all their work. I'd like you to take notice of the exits. There are two on this side of the cafeteria. There's one in the back through the gym, and then you can go out the front on either side to go out the front door if you ever need to. So I'd like to thank you for coming and your generous donations out front. And right now, I'd like you to enjoy the show.
Oh, no, but she folks will never come for me, so I gotta go find them. I don't care. I'm getting out of here. Okay, I'm ready. Take you off. Annie,
one before you can. You're definitely colder this one.
Oh, I don't mind. Okay.
Well,
friendly and intelligent. Mississippi, Capricorn. have anyone like that here.
What about this child right here?
Oh, Annie, you do not want her.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mrs. Warbucks' house?
Oh, boy, I would love to. You can have anyone here but not Annie.
Perhaps I should call the boyfriend
then. If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you get.
It's Annie I want.
Oh, boy!
And if you'll get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
She don't have no coat.
Then we'll buy her one.
Oh, boy, I can hardly believe it.
Come along, Annie. Mrs. Warbucks is right outside.
I can hardly believe it.
She
can hardly believe it.
Yes, sir.
In grace, fill Gary's notebook.
Who's that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks, the orphan who will be with us for Christmas.
That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. He said it wasn't me, so I chose a girl.
Well, I suppose she'll have to do. Annie, home. Annie, what?
Oh, I'm just Annie, Mr. Warbucks. Sir, I ain't got no last name. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
Oh, no, I couldn't be happier. Graves, we'll start the figures on the iron ore shipments from Toledo, too.
No.
What are we supposed to do with this child? Well, Annie, I guess we have to do something special on your first night. Would you like to go to the movies?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
Can you go to the Roxy, an ice cream seller at Uncle Myers, and a handsome cab ride around Central Park?
Golly!
Great. Forget about the temptation for tonight. Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Something's the matter, Annie.
Well, it's just I thought you were going to take me.
I'm afraid I'll be far too busy tonight. Now, Annie, I've been away for 6 weeks on a man is running a multi-billion-dollar corporation.
Oh, sure, Mr. Warbucks. I understand. That's okay.
Drake.
Yes, sir.
Get our coats. Grace, look.
Oh, gee.
Grace, look up too, of course.
Yes, sir. Which car will you be wanting, sir?
Duesenberg. No, wait, the child's going to be jumped on the orphanage. We'll walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Why not? It's 145 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Ah, smell those bus fumes. Is New York the air of New York? Come on, you silly folks. Why don't I get to the Roxy before the prices change? Thank you. friends.
Need not be over.
God, I hope not.
Good afternoon, Kevin.
What, were we already fed up with Annie?
On the contrary. Miss Hannigan, this has to be signed and sent back to the board of orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Because Mr. Warburton is so taken with Annie that he wants to adopt her.
A daughter? Annie? The daughter of a millionaire?
The daughter of a billionaire.
Would you please excuse me for a second? Got any more wonderful news?
Merry Christmas, Miss Hannigan.
Oops, pardon me, Paul. Hi, sis. Long time no see.
Rooster, they finally let you out of prison? What were you in for this time?
Someone bullied her, so they swindled about $1,100.
Why you say that?
Because the rooster swindled.
Do me a favor. Get out of here.
So who was that blonde you bumped into when I came in? What's your $100?
She works for the Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks?
An orphan here is getting adopted by him.
Crummy orphan.
Yeah, living on a lap of luxury. Two Annie's and a bunch of skits. It ain't fair how he scrounged for their Warbucks while she gets Warbucks.
The little brat. It ain't fair, at least your life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living bad.
Maybe she hopes to see that little lady getting more bucks.
Thank you.
Yes, Mr. President. No, I'm not asking for your help. I'm telling you, God can do something about it. All right, talk about it on
Friday.
Listen, Mr. President. Why don't we bury the hatchet and you and Mrs. Roosevelt come here for some supper and Christmas Eve?
You will?
Wonderful. Bye, Mr. President. Grace, I don't want Democrats to eat.
Yes, sir.
Maxine to Pace?
Maxine.
Fine, I'm going to give it to her, and then I'm going to tell her I want to adopt her.
She's
going to
be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her down here.
Yes, sir. Hello.
And if you made the man talk.
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. No, Annie. I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made a promise to myself. One way or another, I'm going to be rich. Very rich.
That was a good idea.
But I later realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you're alone, you have no one to share your life with, you might as well be broke. I was at Tiffany's yesterday. I picked this up for you.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Robux. For me?
It's a silver locket, Annie. I know it's the old one that you always wear. And I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new locket. Here, why don't you take the old one off and put the new one on?
No, I don't want a new one.
Annie, what is it?
This locket. My mother and father left it for me. Well, they left me at the orphanage. And a note, too. I know I'm real lucky to be here with you for Christmas and all, but one thing I want in the world is to find my real mother and father and be like real kids, folks of my own.
It's all right, Annie. I'll find your parents. I'll find your parents for you.
Shh. Mr. Webber will find your mother and father if he has to put everyone on the job to use them, if he has to pull every political string there is people.
Up to and through the White House. Annie, give me your locket. I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace it and figure out who bought it.
Okay, maybe they should have my note, too.
You watch, Annie. Maybe meeting your mother and father in a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, boy, I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
Thank you.
welcome to America's favorite radio program, The Austin Now and Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy.
And now what God sponsors, Austin Toothpaste, reminding everyone that you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say Austin. Yes, this is your old softie, Mrs. Healy's boy, Bert, saying, until next week, same time, same station, good night. Radio coast to coast, she's famous.
Wish I was on the radio.
Me too.
Who wants to be on a dumb old radio anyway?
I do, so for all the hours of smile, this is Bert Healy saying.
$50,000 reward.
Huh? What would I do with that? Yeah.
Here's go.
Yeah.
We were terrible trolls back then, and we had to leave our baby here on the front steps.
Our little girl, our Annie.
You're Annie's parents? I cannot believe it. Where do you say you come from again?
Little farm in Canada, where they got lots of chickens, ducks, geese, and roosters. Gotcha, sis.
Rooster, I would have never noticed you in 100 years.
Cool jag and cool worlds, too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
We need your help, sis. We think this about Annie and how to pull this thing off.
What's in it for me?
Three ways split.
Half?
Half?
Half.
Okay, 25 grand each. We got to do it fast. Get the money, get the kid, get out of here.
The kid's the problem. What are we going to do with her afterwards?
No problem. When I want something to disappear, it disappears. Good. Get the 50 grand, blow this crummy town, me and Lil Winter.
Where? Oh, yeah.
You
Who are you?
Honey, where are your mom and dad?
Fudge is hanging around, Fudge, and this here is Wedge Shirley.
And you're Annie Wedge.
Annie Wedge?
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
I'll expect my mom to know who we are, so here's Annie Wedge at the beginning and our driver's license.
She had that accent.
Baby girl named Anna Elizabeth Fudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Fudge, New York, October 28th, 1922. October 28th, that's my birthday.
Look, Ralph, Annie's wearing a locket.
We left Annie here at the orphanage and gave her half the locket to the other half. Look, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph, she's our Annie.
Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
We ain't got money. We're glad to give you whatever.
So you haven't heard of offering a certified check for $50,000 to any person who can prove that they're Annie's parents?
No, sir, we don't want any.
On the other hand, Ralph, remember that big farm up in New Jersey? With $50,000, we can afford to bring Annie upright in the country.
Do you mind if Annie stays here until tomorrow, Christmas? Do you come and pick her up with a check?
Whatever you prefer, sir.
Bye, Annie, love.
Until tomorrow, honey. And Annie will be spending the rest of your life with us. Pardon me, dollface.
Well, this is...
wonderful news.
Drink champagne.
Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley
know we do about the wrong names after all.
In the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
You guys can just scoot back there.
Oh, Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Same here. I don't know you anywhere.
Let me introduce you to everybody. You know my secretary, Miss Farrell, and this is the President of the United States. And this is my brother, Drake.
Sir, this is just a man from the FBI.
Ah, now it all fits together.
Sir, this is Mrs. Munch.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
We weren't bothered because the mom just came to pick up Annie and his check.
Ah, oh, yes, of course, the check. Here it is, Mr. Mudge. $50,000 certified.
Certified pay to the order of the jig is up?
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as
Brewster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip.
Louis, turn them over.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Look, Vince, there's presents here for us all.
Believe you find this because they're accomplice.
No, I've only seen them since yesterday.
Come off it, Abby.
Annie, tell him how nice it was to you.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry for seeing him here. But what's the one thing you always tell me?
Never tell a lie. Right?
Miss Hannigan is gone for good.
Yay!
You won't have to work anymore.
Yay!
Yes, girls, for you and perhaps all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. A new deal. Hey, I rather like that. A new deal.
So do I, Franklin. A new deal.
Thank you.
Missy, Annie, and Sarah. Santa.